Hello everyone, how are you? Today I'll show you how to make this animated bar graph using Blender. Let's begin. Let's delete this and reset the camera's location and rotation. And let's place the camera. First, let's add the numbers. You can change the font if you want. I won't because I'm feeling lazy today. Change the line spacing. Duplicate it, and in edit mode I'm gonna write the other numbers for my chart. Because this text is horizontal, change the word spacing, not the line spacing. Duplicate this one and let's make some underscores for the lines in the graph. Let's copy these two underscores just because it is faster than typing them again. This is me learning how to count. Change the line spacing. Now for the bars, let's add a plane. And in edit mode, just select the top edge and with the move tool, move it in the Z axis. In object mode, duplicate it. And again, in edit mode, just make it as tall or short as you want to. And let's do it again. And again, and again. Let's animate the bars now. Create a new shape key and now create a second one. With the second one selected, go to edit mode and with the top edge selected, use the move tool and make the plane smaller in the Z axis. Go to object mode and let's try it. any words. With this value set as 1, go to frame 1 and make a keyframe. Move to whatever frame you want the bars to be in their final size. Change the value to 0 and make a keyframe. And let's do the exact same thing with the other bars. I chose 30 frames per second. And here we have our bars animated already. My bars are animated in different timings, as you can see, but you could keyframe all the shape keys bars in the same keyframe so they grow at the same time. I'm gonna change my keyframes a bit. I want to take a moment to tell you that if you want to support the channel, you can now leave a tip on my Ko-fi profile so I can keep making this type of content. And because not all my bars have the same length, but they are all animated in the same amount of frames, some bars are slower and the tallest ones are faster, so I arrange the keyframes taking that into account. Now let's animate the numbers. Convert the text into mesh and in edit mode select all and let's separate them. And now showing the numbers that are in the same row. The reason I put all the numbers as one text at first, even though I knew I would separate them, is so I could use the line spacing for having them equally separated from each other and so I could align them to the right. For me that was easier than moving each number with the move tool. Now when I scale the numbers they scale towards the center, but in my final animation they appear from the bottom center. See the difference? That's because we need to change the origin to the bottom. Let's do the same with the others. Now let's do the same with the bottom numbers. And after doing this a couple of times, I figured out using shortcuts was faster. And here we have the origins. And they seem to be working fine. Select the numbers. Individual origins, go to the frame you want the numbers to be full size, keyframe the scale, now go to frame 1, scale, make a keyframe, scale 0, make a keyframe, and let's repeat the process with the other numbers. Now let's animate the lines. It's the same process we just did. Convert to mesh. And change the origins again. Hopefully your origins will be more straight than mine. And here we have the overall effect. Choose a standard if you want the flat looking colors. And change the word color, which is our background color. I already chose my colors, by the way, so you'll see me copying the color values instead of picking them. I chose emissive materials to help with the flat looking colors, and that way you won't need to add any lights to the scene. I wanted all the numbers and the lines to share the same material, so I linked them with the material I just made. For the bars, I chose some gradient materials, but first a message from the near future. When you're making the materials, be sure to be on the last frame so you can see the bars in their full length. Don't do what I did, basically. Actually, I want an emissive material, so let's disconnect this one, change to emission, and rotate the colors. Choose our material and make a new one so we can pick different colors. And now I just repeated the same process for all the bars, so I'm just gonna show you my final materials and the color codes in case you want to use the same ones. And if you want some glow in the materials, you can enable bloom and change the emission values. Then I played with the interpolation, the handle type and the easy mode a bit. I moved the keyframes. If your bars are showing when they are supposed to be invisible, it's because we need to tweak them a bit. Go to edit mode and using the grab tool just move the top edge. And there you have it. Repeat the same process if you have the same problem with another bar. And I want this line to be forward the bar. And we are ready. Choose your folder to render this animation, change the name. We don't need the alpha channel and just render animation. And that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!